If you've never built a robot, or touched an Arduino, or, I don't know, seen a Somnox. This video is for you.
Wow!
A lot of people have been asking me how to get started with robotics. And do you know what I say to that?
Who, me?
Yeah, I mean seriously, who wants to get robotics advice from a girl who put a robot in a tater tot? I did that. But regardless, I'm flattered.
And I'm also a giver.
So today, we're gonna be building this. But Junie, why do we need shark fins? I mean, we're people, we're not—
Shark people.
I'll tell you. Supplies. For this project, we're gonna need one Arduino.
Boy.
What?
One Arduino. One micro servo motor. One 9-volt battery cap with DC. One red jumper wire. One white. One black. One 9-volt battery.
And if you want specifics on any of the parts that I'm using, I've included all of that in the description. Because I'm a good person.
Sharp people.
A lot of people ask me how I have the motivation to make one fully functioning and revolutionary robot per week.
How?
I used to be like them. Like you. Human. Until I realized I could be more!
Bingo!
With the Shark Robot, you can be more. Better. Because when you're wearing the shark, you are the shark.
It tastes good. Wiring. Wiring this robot is going to be fairly simple, and since we're only using this little servo, we don't need an external battery or even a breadboard. Yeah, I know it's crazy.
Yeah, it's insane.
But there are some things that we need to pay attention to. Wire colors!
Yeah, I literally took the time to draw this.
As you can see here, the brown wire goes to ground, the red one goes to power, and the yellow wire goes to signal. And luckily, there's a song to help you remember this.
Power signal! Ground.
It haunts me. For the power, we're gonna connect it to the Arduino's 5-volt pin. And for the ground, we're gonna use this pin here. The signal is essentially the pin that sends the motor directions. As you can see, we also have it set to pin 9 in the code.
This is the code. In addition to focus, the shark fin keeps your brain icy quick.
Math!
What kind of math?
Long division! Now, we're gonna be assembling the fin for our shark.
Ah! What? In the world?
Nothing, I just remember that this whole thing is kind of like summer camp.
Today, at Science Craft Fun Camp, we will be cutting out two equal triangles. All you have to do is get your scissors and your poster paper, and boom! Two equal triangles. Two equal triangles. Two equal triangles.
What just happened? Now, in order to secure the fin to the motor, we're gonna have to cut a 2-inch piece of popsicle stick. For some reason, I called this a toothpick and I just didn't feel like refilming it. And once we've done that, we're gonna drill
two
holes in the
popsicle stick
in order to attach it to the servo.
I'm so sorry you had to witness that.
And now, the only thing left to do is to put it on our head. And you can do this using just a variety of items. Ribbon, necktie, cloth, belt, two pieces of tape taped together.
And now, Junie will share a shark tale from her past.
I mean, my past is over, but like, okay. I've never had a tale of a whale or a whale of a tale that watched me sail in a pail quite like with my shark fin. With my shark fin. I've never had a tail of a whale or a whale of a tail that watched me sail in a pail quite like with my shark fin. With my shark fin.
I've never had a tail of a whale or a whale of a tail that watched me sail in a pail quite like with my shark fin. With my shark fin.
Brack, 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 brack.
I've never had a tail of a whale or a whale of a tail that watched me sail in a pail quite like with my shark fin.
And that is why you should learn robotics.
Thank you so much for watching this video, and if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a thumbs up. If you haven't already, be sure to subscribe. I love doing science for people.
That's it.